Why, hello everyone! I didn't see you there. Even though I wrote the script, set up the recording, and published this video on a public platform, the thought that someone might actually watch it never crossed my mind. Well, now that you are here, I'm sure you're wondering where I've been all this time. I mean, I haven't done anything noteworthy since 1991, when I single-handedly ended the Cold War. Long story, don't want to get into it now. The point is, I've been on a mission. For most of my natural life, I've traveled the cosmos, searching for the worst channel on YouTube. For I know, if I can destroy them, their influence will melt away, and world peace will finally be achieved. And, in terms of success, it could have gone better. Okay, I may have wasted my entire life trying and failing to achieve an impossible goal, but it's not like there's no upside to all this. While trying to find the worst channel on YouTube, I may have accidentally found the best channel on YouTube. Despite the fact that this mission couldn't have been more of an object failure if I actively tried, it's a failure in the best way possible. You see, there's this guy called Dustin Nunn, and the second we locked eyes, I was in love. If there's one thing I value in my content, it's consistency, and Dustin is even more consistent than me, and I locked myself in a void of blue and purple stripes that sheathed my eyes from the sins of the outside world. Not only do his videos all have consistently high quality, but all of his thumbnails are exactly the same, so it's like you know you're getting the Dustin Nunn seal of approval whenever you click on one. And keeping in the theme of that consistency, he always talks about the same topics, over and over again, such as why he doesn't like the newest generation of consoles, why he doesn't like the newest generation of consoles, why he doesn't like the newest generation of consoles, and am I forgetting something? Oh yeah, why BLM is a terrorist organization! Now, sadly, not everyone seems to have the same appreciation for Dustin as I do. There have been multiple attempts to critique him, all of which have been shot down by the Lord himself. However, in light of all this blasphemy, it has made me think about some incredibly minuscule issues I have with one of his videos. Namely, this one, where he clears up any misunderstanding about how he doesn't hate the LGBT... alphabet community. It's incredibly funny, I assure you. Now, as an LGBT person myself, you can imagine that I'd have some quarrels. I'm sure some of you are thinking, Bennett, what are you talking about? You're not binary. There isn't an N in LGBT. And to that I say, you're right! There's three! Before I begin, I'd like to clear up that just because I happen to disagree with this one video, that doesn't mean I dislike Dustin's channel as a whole. How could I? If I did, this video would be like throwing a pebble at a Mongol horde and expecting it to intimidate them. So, without further ado... let's dive in.
Hello everyone. Dustin here, and today I'd like to talk to you viewers about why I do not hate the LGBT alphabet community.
Well, thank goodness you don't, otherwise you'd be alienating your prime demographic. Me!
Hate is a very strong word. Now, in my past videos, I have been getting attacked by members of the LGBT community.
Oh, come on, calling it harassment is being a bit overdramatic. You're telling me that standing outside of someone's house with a picket sign and firing projectile weaponry whenever they're in my line of sight is harassment now? God help us all if so.
The alphabet LGBT community have been around since the 1960s. The 60s was where there was peace, love, psychedelic rock music, the hippies, the pill popping, the marijuana, and other kind of drugs. And all other kinds of drugs. And the hippie bands.
I mean, why stop there? The 60s were just so amazing, it feels like you're just scratching the surface, for instance.
Well, fast forward later to 2015, President Obama and the Supreme Court turned the good old U.S. of A. Turned the good old U.S. of A. into the 50 states of gay.
Okay, for those who don't get the joke, let me explain. What he's doing here is replacing the A in US of A with gay, thus implying that the United States are in fact gay. Being gay means to be lighthearted and carefree, so calling the US gay is funny because in actuality, everyone who lives there is in visceral pain.
In other words, Obama made LGBT rights in all 50 states legal, and in my opinion, the LGBT rights need to be reversed.
It looks like someone didn't read the UNO instruction booklet. Yes, you can change the turn order by playing a reverse card, however, it can be easily changed back by playing another reverse card. I doubt your solution would work out long term.
In other words, banned. In October 8, 2009, Obama signed... this is from my read on Wikipedia here.
Oh no, you're reading off Wikipedia? You can't trust them! They've been spreading the lie that Ratatouille is a film! In actuality, it's propaganda to convince us that humans are motivationless husks with no talents, and the only reason we progress as a species is because of the rats that control our brains, and we don't know they're there because we can't see on top of our heads!
In October 8, 2009, Obama signed a Matthew Shepard and James Byrd Jr. hate crime Matthew Shepard and James Byrd Jr. Hate Crimes Prevention Act, a measure that expanded the 1969 United States federal hate crime law to include crimes motivated by a victim's actual or perceived gender, sexual orientation, gender identity, or disability. Now, I can put up with people with disabilities like autism, retardation slash Down syndrome, blindness, and all that. But I'm sorry, the gayness has got to go.
I know, right? In this free country, if I can't just walk up to someone, ask them if they're homosexual, and if they say yes, hit them over the head with my model semi-automatic rifle, I'm too scared to use real guns, don't tell the kids at school, they'll think I'm a weenie, then quite frankly, we've degraded as a nation.
And I'm for straight rights, though.
Honestly, this is the only point in the entire video that I genuinely agree with. American straight people in this country of America have been missing many crucial rights that they simply could not live without, including, but not limited to, the right to bear live Komodo dragons.
So anyways, on October 30th, 2009, Obama lifted the ban on travel to the United States to those infected with HIV, which was celebrated by the Immigration Equality. On December 22nd, 2010, if you want to say it, Obama signed the Don't Ask, Don't Tell Repeal Act of 2010, which fulfilled a key promise he made in 2008 presidential campaign to end the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy of 93 that had prevented LGBT rights from serving openly in the United States Armed Forces.
Well, that's a bit of an odd complaint. I thought right-wingers loved shooting people.
And 2016, Obama also ended a policy that banned transgender people from serving openly in the military. And it's the Illinois State Senate in 96. In 96, Obama had said he favored legalizing same-sex marriage rights. By the time the Senate runs down to four, he said he supported civil unions and domestic partnerships for same-sex workers, but opposed same-sex marriages. And 2008, he reaffirmed this position by stating, I believe marriage between a man and a woman, I am not in favor of gay marriage. Meanwhile, 2012, shortly after the official launch of his campaign for re-election as president, Obama said his views had evolved, and he publicly affirmed his personal support for legalization of same-sex marriage rights, becoming the first sitting U.S. president to do so.
During the second inaugural address on January 21st, 2013, Obama became the first U.S. president in office to call for full equality for gay Americans. Or should I say LGBT alphabet soup group Americans?
I would prefer if you referred to us as the dominant species, thank you very much.
Our journey is not complete until our gay alphabet brothers and sisters are treated like anyone else under the law. For if we are truly created equal, then love we commit to one another must be equal as well. And hate to stop right there, but I'm going to say, screw Obama. First he said he wasn't for gay rights, and now he was for it later on. Hypocrite.
I think you're mixing up your definitions a tad. Being a hypocrite just means that you were spat out of the Earth's fiery core with the sole purpose of convincing everyone you meet to worship the prophet Lucifer. It doesn't mean anything nearly as bad as going back on your previous claims.
So anyways, where was I? Oh yeah. This was the first time that a president mentioned gay rights or the word gay in an inaugural address. In 2013, the Obama administration filed briefs that urged the Supreme Court to rule in favor of same-sex couples in the cases of Hollingsworth versus Perry regarding the same-sex rights and U.S. versus Windsor regarding the Defense of Marriage Act. Then, following the Supreme Court's 2015 decision on Obergefell, what's that word? Where's his name? Obergefell versus Hodges. I'm not sure if that's pronounced Obergefell or Obergefell.
It's actually pronounced obituary.
Wiener. God did not create people to get sex change operations, and God did not create the bisexuals to love the opposite genders, sex/opposite sexes. You know what I mean? Everything in the Holy Bible is fact, especially the anti-gay ones.
You know, Justin, this is the only part of your video that I genuinely agree with. In fact, I agree so much that I even have my very own handy-dandy pocket Bible. Hey, wait a minute, what is this thing? My copy was written in Impact font and had a reference to Icon as Cheeseburger Cat in every other passage. What's this version? Psalm 151? Judaeus 2357? The even older testament?
I know some of the most Bibles have been... Some other Bibles say different things. But I'm sticking with the anti-gay Bible zone.
Wait a minute, there are pro-gay versions of the Bible? Is that what Joseph's Technicolor Dreamcoat was all about?
Because they are full of facts.
And again, I have to agree, those other Bibles have like two facts total. In fact, rumor has it, those versions of the Bible were written by a person.
I mean, the stories include real things that happened before you, me, and everyone else existed. Included Adam and Eve, Jesus Christ, Moses, David and Goliath, and so many others. But Jesus in particular, if Jesus had not died for our sins, and if he had not gotten nailed to the cross,
then the lowercase letter D would have way less religious significance.
I know it was sad that he had to get nailed that way. That was brutal, because I've seen the Jesus movies before in the past, but my point being is, getting back on topic, my point being is, if Jesus had not gotten nailed to the cross, we humans today would not have existed.
Dustin, my guy, humans already existed. Would the naughty LGBT folk who were probably being persecuted anyway have prevented us from procreating?
I mean, let's face it, Jesus died for our sins. So, like I said, I don't hate repeating myself, but all of us humans repeat ourselves. It's a habit. We all can't help that.
Well, you could say the same thing about being LGBT, but I don't see you giving them a pass.
But like I said, I do not hate the LGBT alphabet soup, ABC, XYZ community.
You forgot Delta.
I just don't agree with them, okay? I just don't agree with them.
And how you can disagree with someone as a human being, I'd be hard-pressed to tell you, but if there's one thing I've learned in my travels, it's that it's unwise to denounce the holy word of Dustin Nunn. I mean, his name is literally Nunn. I can't think of an easier way to get smote.
If you want to be LGBT, well, that's all fine and dandy.
But you shouldn't have rights.
But you don't have to push your rights on children or anyone else. I remember when I was on YouTube.
Past tense, as in he isn't currently on YouTube, which would certainly explain a few things.
I came across a video where these drag queens... Oh, and by the way, God did not create drag queens either. Forgot to mention that. Like I said in one of previous videos, there was this, these drag queens having this storybook session with these little boys and girls, and these drag queens were educating the boys and the girls about drag queens, how they work, you know. And one of the drag queens asked one of these boys, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" And one of them said, "I want to be a superhero." And one of the drag queens said, "Well, you can be a drag queen superhero."
I mean, are they wrong?
You can be a drag queen superhero. And did the boy or one of the boys say that he or they wanted to be a drag queen superhero or superheroes? No. They just wanted to be superheroes. But here's the thing, spoiler alert, superheroes don't exist in real life.
And neither do LGBT people.
There's just heroes. Superheroes only exist in fiction. You know, like your Captain Marvels, your Shazams, your Spider-Mans, your Supermans, your Incredible Hulks, and the Fantastic Fours and all that, you know. Yeah. Well, anyways, getting back on topic. The gay folks have been bullying and pushing their rights on straights for years and years.
My good sir, this is pure slander. The fact that you claim I would push my rights onto you is absurd. Now, if you were to accuse me of pushing my lefts onto you, I can totally see that. I do it every other weekday, but I feel the need to take a bold stance against claims such as these.
We straight folks, we heterosexuals, including yourselves and I, we don't hate the gays. We just don't agree with them, and we don't bully them. The gays bully us.
So this is normally where I would put another one of my patented smart and clever points, but like the place in the script where there should be a line of dialogue doesn't actually say anything, so I'm just gonna say whatever comes to mind. So what's your guys' opinion on I Am Me?
And for those idiot straight folks out there who support the LGBT shit, also push gay rights on us, and bully us and shove it down our throats. I'm sorry, but I know you gays don't like hearing what the Bible says, but I'm sorry, it is what it is. God created love between straights only, and that is the way it should be.
I know I could just go for the bog standard point of, if God didn't create LGBT people, how do they even exist? But anyone who tries to make that argument is a coward. They're too scared to admit what's really going on here. So let me get this straight. You see LGBT people defy the will of God, and that gives you less respect for us? We're doing the one thing none of you were brave enough to do. You should be worshiping us, frankly.
That is the way it should be. Always, forever. Like I said, I hope this whole LGBT crap gets banned.
Oh, really? You want to ban LGBT practices as a whole? Really? You think it's that simple? LGBT people have been through persecution, plagues, natural disasters, violations of the First Amendment. The wrath of God couldn't keep us under wraps. So what on earth do you think some old fart in an office is gonna do?
Well, I said it needs to be banned, but still, it needs to be banned forever.
Mm-hmm, yes, of course, very cool. But what exactly do you plan to do after forever plus one? Checkmate, Dusty!
And Obama and the Supreme Court are to blame for it. Are to blame for legalizing the gay crap. They are. Being gay is, and always forever will be, wrong.
Hi everyone, I thought I'd just cut in to clarify that he doesn't hate LGBT people, he just disagrees with them. Personally, I think he could have done a better job getting that across.
How many times do I have to repeat myself? How many times do all of us have to repeat ourselves?
Who else are you referring to? Because last I checked, you're the only one in your room.
We've been saying, being gay is wrong, nonstop. And do gay people listen to us? No.
But the gay people are the ones pushing their rights.
But hey, if they want to find out for themselves, that's all fine by me. But me, I'm not gay. I'm straight, and I'm attracted to straight women only. Especially those who are anti-gay like me. So, I'm just rambling on.
You know, Dustin, this is the only part of your video that I actually agree with.
So anyways, hope you folks enjoyed this video about what I had to say. And if I see any anti-homophobic comments saying I hate LGBT folk, which I don't, they'll be blocked and deleted. If I see any hateful comments saying that I mooch off my parents, which I don't, they will be blocked and deleted. If I see anybody in the comments making fun of me, they'll be blocked and deleted.
I would never. Anyways, that's the end of this video. Sorry I couldn't provide more proper rebuttals, it's just that even his worst videos are superior to most countries' governments, and I'm only mostly joking. I hope I was able to open up your eyes to the gospel of Dustin Nunn, and even if I didn't, that's okay. Heaven's not everyone's cup of tea. Woo! I'm glad I'm done with this commentary. It means I get to go back to playing my favorite video game, Crash Bandicoot 4. It's about time. Hey, where did this thing come from? Well now, I'm sorry viewers, it appears I've made a grave oversight. Give me a moment. Hey guys, you'll never believe me, but I finally found the worst channel on YouTube!